Hi. Please let me know if I am visible, audible, and we can start on today's topic of Parivartan Yoga. Yes. Hey, let me know if I'm audible. Please comment if I'm audible and we can start. Just completing my for today so that we can start. And let me know if I'm audible. Please comment. Okay, I think we are good enough to start. So, yes, today's topic was is Parivartan Yoga and how a Parivartan Yoga takes place, what is the general interpretation of Parivartan Yoga, and how it should be interpreted actually. So, if we first of all, what is Parivartan Yoga? Every planet rules some house signs, right? Sun rules Leo, Moon rules Cancer, Mercury rules Gemini and Virgo, Jupiter rules Sagittarius, Pisces, Saturn rules Aquarius and Capricorn, and Venus rules Taurus and Libra. So every planet is ruling some sign. So Parivartan Yoga happens when a planet is sitting in another planet's sign and that planet is sitting in this planet's sign. Means Sun is sitting in Cancer and Cancer's Lord's Moon is sitting in Sun sign, that is Leo. Mercury is sitting in Libra and Venus is sitting in Gemini. So when planets exchange their signs, then it is called parivartan yoga. It is also called exchange of signs. It is also called mutual reception. These are the common terms which are used for parivartan yoga. We can take any example. Let's say Saturn is in Leo and Sun is in Aquarius. This is also a parivartan yoga. Okay, so this is way how parivartan yoga is formed, when two planets are exchanging each other's signs. It is like I am sitting in my friend's home and my friend is sitting in my home. So this is the way parivartan yoga takes place, and it is commonly found, especially between Venus and Mercury. It is very commonly found because Venus and Mercury are very close to each other. So if Mercury is in Libra, then there is always a possibility that Venus is in Virgo. So there, and that's where the exchange happens. Now the general interpretation of this parivartan yoga, if we check online, it is that all the planets which form a parivartan yoga start behaving like friends. Okay, even if it is an enemy, parivartan yoga is happening between two enemies planets, they become friend for the time being and they cooperate with each other. Okay, it is even if Mars and Saturn are in parivartan yoga or Sun and Saturn are in parivartan yoga, even then they will start behaving like friends because they are sitting in each other's house. It's like you are sitting in your enemy's house and your enemy is sitting in your house. So you are better to take care of each other's house because anyone can spoil anyone's house, right? So that's the way the general interpretation is. Means generally you will find such kind of interpretation online that during parivartan yoga, all the both the planets will start behaving like friends and they will cooperate with each other. Then it is said that parivartan yoga between two friends are very very auspicious, rather than between two enemies. Like if you have parivartan yoga between Jupiter and Moon, then it is one of the most auspicious parivartan yoga because they are the best friends and they are sitting in each other's house. So they are liking each other's house and they are liking each other's company, the mutual exchange. Whereas if parivartan yoga is between Mars and Saturn or Sun and Saturn, then it is not that beneficial. Okay, so they say that parivartan yoga is always more beneficial when it is happening between two friend planets, okay, rather than enemy planets. Then third thing is that there can be a parivartan yoga which also provides a mutual aspect to each other. Means suppose Saturn is in Leo, then the example which I was giving, Saturn was in Leo and Sun was in Aquarius. Now they are exchanging each other's house, but they are also aspecting each other. Okay, so this is also one of the beneficial because it is more energy exchange between two planets. Okay, suppose Jupiter. I will try to explain in a better way. Suppose Jupiter is in Gemini and Mercury is in Sagittarius. Now Mercury is sitting in Jupiter's sign, Jupiter is sitting in Mercury's sign. They are exchanging, it is parivartan yoga, but at the same time Mercury is aspecting its own sign, Gemini. It is making Gemini sign or that house very very potential. Okay, it is aspecting its own sign. Likewise, Jupiter is aspecting its own sign. So it is further making the Sagittarius house where Sagittarius falls all more strong. Okay, so that's what I was telling about Saturn and Sun. Saturn in Leo and Sun in Aquarius. Sun is aspecting back at Leo. It is making Leo house Leo sign very strong. Likewise, Saturn is aspecting Aquarius. It is making Aquarius very strong. So there are two, three ways where, by which a Parivartan Yoga can be very beneficial. First is Parivartan Yoga in itself is beneficial, means Parivartan, as I said, the Parivartan Yoga means exchange of energy. So two planets exchanging energy is itself is a beneficial thing. Second, if it is between two friends. Third is when they are also aspecting each other, then it is more beneficial. Okay, because they are providing strength to each other's sign. Okay, now it goes a little deeper. If the planets involved in Parivartan Yoga are mutual friends and the beneficial planets, okay, friends plus beneficial, okay, it is not or, it is and. They should be friends and they should be benefic planets, then it is best yoga, then it is the best Parivartan Yoga. Okay, if Jupiter and Moon, they are friends and they are also benefic planets, if they both are forming a Parivartan Yoga, then it is best yoga. As always, all the results will be seen during their dashas. Okay, it is a general factor, but it is a good Parivartan Yoga when two benefic and friends are exchanging each other's house. So Jupiter Moon, they both are benefic, they both are mutual friends, so it is a good yoga. Jupiter Venus, now they are benefic but they are not friends. Okay, so the level goes down of results. It is not too harmful, but they are still not good friends. Okay, so the results will be lesser. If planets which are malefic and enemies, okay, then the results are further down, like Saturn Mars or Mars, Saturn Mars or Saturn Sun, they are mutual enemies and they are also malefic planets, enemies plus malefic. So they will also get the results, but they will have to work really hard to get those results of Parivartan Yoga. Okay, plus as Saturn is involved, it will be delayed, it will require great hard work from them. Okay, then mutual friends but enemies means Mars Sun or Mars Jupiter. Here Mars is a natural malefic planet. Okay, so although it is causing a Parivartan Yoga, but it is causing with its malefic energy, so it will make you work really hard to get the benefits of that Parivartan Yoga. So that this is way this is second thing we need to be aware, that which are the planets involved, what are their mutual relationship, and according to that they will give results. If they are friends to each other and they are benefic, then it is best result. But if they are not friends or if they are malefic by nature, then results will come but with delay or hard work. Okay, then most important is that every planet shares something from other planets. Okay, two planets share something, okay, more or less, means there are some planets which don't share anything with other planets, but most of the combination of planets, like even Sun, Saturn, are the biggest enemies. Okay, but they both represent law. Okay, they both represent or share law. So that's what I am trying to say, that all the planets share something. Okay, so whenever a Parivartan Yoga is happening, planets involved, whatever they share is going to be beneficial. Person will get the good results of those things which they share. Okay, which they don't share, person will have to work really hard to achieve things related to those things means, which they don't share. Like I was giving example of Saturn and Sun. Saturn and Sun both represent government, they both represent law, and they both represent discipline. Okay. So Saturn Sun Parivartan Yoga can be very helpful in professions like law or any government service. Okay. It can also make a person very law abiding. He can be most disciplined person. Okay. Saturn, due to this Saturn Sun exchange, Parivartan Yoga. But at the same time, Sun represents father and Saturn represents Sun. Saturn and Sun both are mutual enemies to each other. The friends and the father and son relationship will be harmful. Okay, if there is a Saturn Sun combination, the person can be most law abiding, can be most disciplined person, but his relationship with father or any authority figure can be troublesome. Okay, so this is way if Parivartan Yoga should be interpreted correctly. There are so many layers involved. Okay, it is not a general rule that two planets in Parivartan Yoga are going to bring good results. It depends upon their nature. First of all, if they are beneficial or malefic by nature. Second, their mutual reception means that they are mutual friends, mutual enemies. And third thing is that what they share, what they don't share. Even Jupiter Moon, which are naturally benefic planets, they are the best friends ever, but they don't share most of the things. Okay, so it cannot be a generic rule anywhere in the astrology. Okay, we have to look into the details. Like you asked Mercury and Saturn. Now here Mercury is a benefic planet, Saturn is a malefic planet. They both are friends. Okay, now Mercury, Saturn, just a second. Now Mercury is Mercury is a quick planet. He wants to do quick things and quick results. He wants to achieve quick results. Okay. Saturn is slow. Saturn is slow by nature, so they don't share this name and this thing, right? The quickness and the delay. Mercury is all about reaching somewhere very quickly and doing the jobs and getting the results too quickly. Okay, but Saturn is all about delay. Saturn is all about persistent action. So whenever this person will try to achieve something really quickly, he will have to face some blocks from Saturn. So this is the way they can share many things. The Mercury and Saturn together can share other things and they can get good results. But all Saturn is doing is putting a block of delay and hard work. It is saying that you will get the results from this Parivartan Yoga from Mercury, but you will have to put lots of hard work and delay, then only results are possible. Okay, so like this, two planets can share something and they cannot share something. Whatever they share, they will cooperate with each other. Whatever they don't share, they will not cooperate with each other. Person will have to work really hard in those matters which they don't share. So I will go one by one. Let's try to cover most of the Parivartan Yogas. Okay, thank you. Now, if Sun and Moon are in Parivartan Yoga, that means Sun is in Cancer sign, Moon is in Leo sign. Okay, they both are sattvic planets. Let me see my notes. They both are sattvic planets. They both work for higher goal. So wherever these two planets are sitting and causing a parivartan yoga, person will look for some higher goals in those areas of life, those houses of life, right? Now, but sun is a masculine planet and moon is a feminine planet. So there will be some problems related with masculine and feminine nature. Person will try to approach the house where moon is sitting through feminine nature, through receptivity. But sun, as it is ruling, it is ruling that house. It will make the person to approach that house in a more masculine nature, or means active nature. Okay. So this is way sun and moon can share something and can arise into conflict in some things. Sun and Mars, both are active planets. Both are action oriented. Okay. Sun and Mars combination is happening. Exchange is happening. Parivartan yoga means the sun is in Aries and Mars is in Leo. So they both are in an exchange with each other. They both are very active. Person will be very active. Okay, in achieving his goals. But Mars is impatient. Mars wants results right now. Mars is about impulsive nature. Sun is ready to wait for the right time. Okay, as it is a sattvic planet, it doesn't mind waiting for the right time to get the results. So when Sun and Mars are in conjunction, Mars may feel frustrated. Exchange. So when Sun and Mars are in Parivartan Yoga, Mars will feel frustrated because of the Sun's nature of restricting Mars energy. Okay. Sun Mercury both are planets are related with intellect. Person can be highly intellectual. Okay. But again, Mercury is inconsistent, whereas Sun is consistent. Okay, Mercury is about here and there, everywhere. Mercury wants to know the knowledge of everything. Okay, information about everything. But Sun wants a consistent action. So the problem will be into the focus. It has the intellect, but the problem will be into the focus. They will share the intellect. Person can be highly intellectual, but the problem this person will feel in focusing at something. Okay, because Sun Mercury don't share that thing. Mercury is inconsistent, Sun is consistent. So problem will be in focusing on one thing. Then Sun Jupiter, higher purpose. Sun Jupiter both are sattvic planets and they both work for some higher purpose, some higher goal, bringing some good to the world. Okay, but what they don't share is that Sun wants to be authoritative. Sun has this ego of being authoritative and ruling over others. Jupiter is not of such nature. Jupiter wants to share the information. Jupiter wants to make everyone authoritative, means everyone not authoritative, I would say everyone competent enough. Okay, Jupiter's nature is that everyone should have knowledge and everyone should be competent enough. Okay, Jupiter doesn't want to rule over someone. Okay, so when Sun Jupiter exchange is happening, this can be the conflict or this can be the problem, that there can be ego conflicts. Okay, then Sun Venus, they don't share anything. Okay, Sun is ego, Venus is relationship. You can't have ego and relationship together. Okay, so Sun and Venus don't share anything. So when they are exchanging signs, like Sun is in Libra or Taurus and Venus is in Leo, they are going to face lots of ego conflicts in relationship. So they don't share anything. Then Sun Saturn, as I said, it is a law related placement. Sun is in Capricorn or Aquarius, then Saturn in Leo. It is the person who is very law abiding, who is very he can be from the field of law, he can be judge also, but his relationship with father and authoritative figures can be troublesome, because father son conflict will be there with son's Saturn relationship. Okay, then moon Mars. Again, they don't have to share, they don't share anything. Moon is about nurturing and taking care of others. Moon is about compromising, being flexible, and Mars is our rigid force and actions that I want to achieve this thing. Moon is not about it. Okay, so as they don't share anything, the conflict will always arise into this this thing that Mars will try to achieve, and Moon will say that there is nothing to achieve. I'm ready to be flexible. I'm not rigid. Okay, so that can be the troublesome spot for Moon Mars conjunction, Moon Mars exchange. Moon Mercury again, they both are related with mind and intellect, but the problem is that Moon is peace of mind. Moon wants to achieve peace of mind. Mercury doesn't want to remain in peace. Mercury is again, it is trying to achieve everything. It is trying to get all the information possible. So again, the focus will be the problem with Moon Mercury conjunction exchange. Then Moon Jupiter, best. Whenever Moon Jupiter exchange is happening, it is kind of best, especially if Moon in Sagittarius and Jupiter is in Cancer. Then it is, I think it is also called one of the Mukut Yoga or something like that. So it is one of the best conjunction. But again, Moon is about your own peace or your own happiness. Jupiter is about sharing happiness with others. So again, there will be a conflict. So see, even with the best of the exchange, the exchange between Moon and Jupiter, there is a conflict. Moon is seeking his own happiness and Jupiter wants to share happiness with others. So again, there will be conflict. So then Moon Venus, if Moon Venus are in exchange, then Moon Venus both represents service to others, as taking care of others, serving others. They both are service related oriented planets. So when person is involved in service to others, they both will cooperate. Moon and Venus will cooperate. But again, the problem will be that Moon wants to do it for his own sake, wants to achieve his own peace, while Venus is about serving everyone possible. It sounds completely new when I say that Venus is about service, but Venus' highest representation is service and devotion. That's why Venus gets exalted in Pisces. Normally, we associate Venus with relationship, luxury, wealth, and other materialistic significances, but highest representation of Venus is service. And when Venus serves, it serves for no selfish gains. Moon can serve for selfish gains. Moon wants own peace of mind. So it can make a Moon work for himself rather than Venus works for everyone. Okay. Then Moon Saturn, it is a problematic situation. Whenever this is happening, Saturn is involved anywhere, it is going to create some trouble. Okay, we can understand it now. So Moon Saturn exchange means Saturn is in Cancer and Moon is either in Capricorn or Aquarius. It is going to be troublesome for a person emotionally. No matter how much we say that Moon and Saturn share this or that, but Moon is too gentle to hold on to the energy of Saturn. So there will be some deep emotional issues with person, with his mother, and these issues can be lifelong if person doesn't go into meditation and all. I again and again repeat the same thing. If you want to achieve peace of mind, meditation is only way. Okay. If your moon is reflected even 1% in your chart, meditation is the only way by which you can make it a little better. Otherwise, it is going to be troublesome position. Okay, because moon is your mind. You are supposed to use your mind every day, every moment, right? If moon is not working well, then rest assured that you are in problem. So one thing I recommend to everyone who has even a slightest of affliction on moon is to go into meditation regularly. Okay. Then Mars Mercury. If Mars and Mercury are in action, they both are about skills, technical skills specifically. But the problem will again come that Mars is about focused action, and Mercury is about being everywhere. Mercury is not focused, so the problem will be in the focusing the energy, focusing the on the one skill. Okay, Mercury can be interested in thousand of skills. Mars doesn't want that. Mars wants one focus. Focus on this skill and master it. Okay, so the conflict will arise due to that. Then Mars Jupiter, it is also a great exchange to have. Mars and Jupiter together means they both are masculine planets. They both are very action oriented planets. So the result will be action orientedness, means the person will be very active in taking the right action, taking the right direction to life. Person will be very much active. But again, Mars is impulsive. Mars wants results right now. Okay, he will try to get results as soon as possible, whereas Jupiter tries to get result as per wisdom. Jupiter tries to get result as per knowledge, and one of the wisdom is patience. Okay, Jupiter is ready to be patient. Jupiter is ready to wait till the right moment. Okay, so again the conflict will come where Mars wants to achieve everything right now, but Jupiter will say, let's wait for some time. Then Mars Venus. It is a desire-oriented exchange, Mars-Venus conjunction or Mars-Venus exchange. It is a desire-oriented exchange. Person can be very desireful and will work hard to attain its desires. But again, the difference is Mars is own desires, Venus is others' desires. Venus is all about serving others. Venus is all about devoting yourself to a higher cause. Okay. So that's where the conflict will come. Mars will try to attain his own desires, whereas Venus will say that let's look at the desires of all the people around. Okay. Then Mars Saturn conjunction, again, they both are active planets, but the exchange will be very active, very action oriented. But the problem will again come as Mars is very impulsive. He wants to be quick, whereas Saturn is slow. Okay, so the end result is frustration. Mars wants to achieve something, but Saturn says, no, it is not the right time. Okay, so the end result will be frustration due to Mars Saturn. Saturn is only putting the block of delay and hard work. After Saturn's maturity age, things will be smooth. Okay, till then it is all about hard work. Mercury, Jupiter, they both are knowledge oriented planets. If Mercury Jupiter exchange is happening, लाइक मर्क्यूरी इज इन सैजिटेरियस, जुपिटर इज इन जेमिनाई, मर्क्यूरी इन पाइसिस, जुपिटर इज इन वर्गो. देन दे बोथ आर वेरी नॉलेज ओरिएंटेड प्लैनेट्स. दे बोथ इफ पर्सन इज नॉलेज ओरिएंटेड, ही वांट्स टू गेन मोर नॉलेज, ही कैन गेट इट. ओके, द बोथ द प्लैनेट्स विल सपोर्ट हिम इन गेटिंग नॉलेज. बट मर्क्यूरीज नेचर इज अबाउट डिटेल ओरिएंटेड. मर्क्यूरी वांट्स टू बी नेट पिकी. ओके, एंड जुपिटर सीज द बिगर पिक्चर. जुपिटर इज नॉट अबाउट डिटेल्स. ओके, सो द प्रॉब्लम विल अराइव व्हेन सच थिंग्स हैपन, दैट मर्क्यूरी विल गो इनटू द डिटेल्स ऑफ द इंफॉर्मेशन ऑन नॉलेज, whereas Jupiter will say that okay, details are not that much important, let's look at the bigger picture and higher goal, we can neglect all those details. Okay, so this is where the problem comes with the Mercury and Jupiter exchange. Likewise, Mercury Venus exchange, they both are desire oriented planets, they both are creative skillful planets, but again Venus is relationship and Mercury is our nitpicky nature, so they can be very detail oriented in relationship. Means you didn't do this, you didn't do that, all these type of things can be troublesome. So this exchange can be troublesome for relationship. Otherwise, in creative skills, it can be very very good exchange to have. Then, as we discuss Mercury Saturn, that they both are detailed oriented planet, but Mercury wants to achieve things quickly. Mercury wants to achieve things right now because it is a quick planet, quick moving planet. But Saturn is all about delay and frustration, so Saturn will delay it. Like this, what we are left with almost three, four. That's completed. Jupiter Venus, they both are teachers, so it is good for their good for person's knowledge. Okay, Jupiter Venus exchange is always good for knowledge of the person. They because they both are teachers, they both the planets can cooperate very well if person is knowledge oriented. But Jupiter is about worldly knowledge. Okay, it just a second. Okay, Jupiter is about worldly knowledge and sharing the knowledge with everyone possible. Venus is more of a more a relationship centric planet, and when Jupiter Venus are in exchange, again relationship will be troublesome. Means see, this exchange will expand the Venus desires, because Venus Jupiter are exchanging, so Venus related desires will be expanded, so that desires and Jupiter's wisdom are in conflict. Jupiter is all about knowledge and wisdom, and Venus here becomes a desire oriented thing. So that conflict may be troublesome for relationship. Otherwise, for knowledge and everything, it can be a good exchange. Okay. Then the Jupiter Saturn. Jupiter Saturn exchange will again put the blocks of delays and hard work, unless and until someone everything related with Saturn is possible after 35. Till then, it is all about hard work. Even if it is Jupiter, it will tell Jupiter to put all the hard work in knowledge, wisdom, and education oriented fields. And then only the Saturn will remove the block and let the Jupiter function on its own. So लास्ट वन इज वीनस सैटर्न। आई डोंट ट्रबलसम फॉर रिलेशनशिप, इट इज ट्रबलसम फॉर एनी काइंड ऑफ रिलेशनशिप बिकॉज सैटर्न विल पुट द ब्लॉक। इट इज फेवरेबल फॉर दे बोथ आर सर्विस ओरिएंटेड प्लैनेट, सो इट इज फेवरेबल फॉर सर्विस एंड इट इज ट्रबलसम फॉर रिलेशनशिप। हियर वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्फ्लिक्ट ऑफ वीनस, वेयर आई टर्म इट एज अ रिलेशनशिप सेंट्रिक प्लैनेट एंड समटाइम्स आई टेल दैट इट इज अ सर्विस ओरिएंटेड प्लैनेट। वीनस हाइएस्ट रिप्रेजेंटेशन इज सर्विस, so if person is service oriented by nature then it is good, okay, then it is he is working on the highest representation of Venus, highest dignity of Venus. But if planet is in a relationship, if a person is in relationship mode, means he wants to get his own desires accomplished, then he is not following the highest representation of Venus and that can be troublesome, okay. So whenever we look at any conjunction, any aspect, exchange, anything, let's take it for granted that there will be some conflicts in relationship front, okay, because it is again the Jiva Karaka and Ajiva Karaka thing that I think I discussed it last time, is that when we talk about relationship and all the living significators, other person is involving. He has his own chart. Okay. So it's not that planets don't want you to get into relationship and all these things. It is just that other person will behave as per his planets, his chart, and you will behave as per your chart. That's it. That is the conflict. That is the adjustment we need to make in this life. Okay. So, thing is that even in this exchange kind of thing, I said that Sun Saturn can be good for Sun Saturn exchange can be good for law or being disciplined, being focused, all these things. But the relationship between father and son can be troublesome because Sun and Saturn are natural enemies. So whenever these things are coming, whenever enemies are exchanging signs, whenever malefic planets are getting involved in exchange, there can be problems with the living significances, your relationship. But when it comes to skills or your career, your creativity, all those things can still give you good results. So this is how an exchange should be interpreted. It is not a blanket rule that any two planets exchanging signs with each other are going to be very very good or benefic. Okay, it depends first on the nature of the planet, if those two planets are benefic or malefic. Even if one is malefic, then it becomes a kind of exchange of hard work and delay. Okay. Second thing, what is the mutual relationship between two planets if they are mutual enemies or mutual friends? So this is the second thing. Most importantly, what they share, what they don't share. Whatever they share, they will cooperate with each other. Whatever they don't share, they will not cooperate with each other. Person will have to put lots of hard work to get those results. We have seen even Moon and Jupiter don't share something. Okay, they are the best of friends. They both are most benefic planets. But even then, they are not sharing some things. For those things, person will have to work really hard. Otherwise, it is a good thing to have exchange because somewhere some cooperation will be there. But it is not a blanket rule that everything will be fine. Okay. So this is what I see in planets exchanging signs. If you have any comment, question, you can always ask. and I will be more than happy to reply. I think it is good for the day. So yeah, basic thing is that every concept is deep. It is not a generic concept. Okay. Thank you. Bye.